Oh shit.
It is both of us. It is.
Rosita. You better not get I got some shit to say to you, Rosita. Look, I've been defending you after all the shit you know has been popping off, but I swear to fucking God, if you get my girl Sasha killed, I'm fucking you up. I know you're a fictional character. I know it would be fucking ridiculous to beat Christian's ass. Christian Serrato, so what the fuck her name is? Ain't she pregnant? I think I read some. Yeah, she just. Every season, it's like another fucking actress gets pregnant. It's like, what the fuck? But, yeah, do not get Sasha killed. I know the actress is. She got the fucking Star Trek shit she's supposed to be starring in. It's like, yo. I really do think I was supposed to pop this at the beginning of the episode. No abs was worth popping the bottle, I'm telling you. Rosita, I'm definitely putting you in my... Damn. Spitting all over the fucking place. Putting you in my next Ranting and Raving video. Her and Laurel from How to Get Away with Murder. Because the last one is Daryl and Connor from How to Get Away with Murder. But this one's going to be Rosita and Laurel. Because they're on the same level. It's like, look, I like you. It's caught up. It's very hard to defend your ass right now. But they're on the same level in that shit. But... I would air my feelings towards those two characters because they're on the same level. They're not fucking. They're grieving. It's making them do dumb shit, and I understand why they do what they do, but they don't think it through. They just lashing out at people. I'll make a video about it. You feel me? This episode, Michelle, baby. When they said it was a Rashawn episode, I thought I was just going to get some Rashawn moments. No, we got a Rashawn episode. They went fucking around. Like, God damn. Anyways. It's not a game. You feel me? Hold on, I got to go back. Shit, I should have paused it or something. But no, that shit was the truth. Whew. I think I was supposed to pop it on. I've been waiting for. They gave us two clips. It was short clips, but hey, it was true. It was good shit. I'm trying to see the abs again, but yeah, the shit was popping. Playing it again. It was like the episode was so fucking good. And it was like, it made me all giddy. And I don't even like romance type shit. It was romance, but Rick and Michonne style. It wasn't like too lovey dovey. It was very casual, like. And, because a lot of people were like, oh, it's gonna change. It's gonna be too. Mushy. Like, no, they ain't fucking Glenn and, what's that motherfucking name, Maggie? They was the mushy couple. A lot of people hated that. I thought it was cute. It fit them. But the shit that they doing with Rick and Michonne and this shit fits them. It's cute and adorable. But at the same time, it's mad casual. It's like, bitch, you got it. Motherfucker, you got it. Motherfucker, we got it! Like, that's just like, they mad cocky with this shit. Because they're the king and queen of the zombie fucking apocalypse. They are... this shit, you feel me? So yeah, this is a cockiness with the oh shit, I'm waiting for the abs. You know, it's a lot of the fuck was I talking about? I didn't even get to the average yet, and I'm already distracted.
What is it?
Oh my fucking god. You don't even know, Sai. You don't even know. Damn. You see that shit? Hold on, click to my camera. Where are you at out of this? But, yeah. Rashawn is one of the... I've done quite a bit of shipping in my time. I don't ship everybody, and not every show I watch, I have a ship. Like Orphan Black. You know, I do Orphan Black reactions. Final season is coming up. That's a couple months. But, I don't have a Orphan Black ship. And there's a lot of ships for Orphan Black. I think close thing to, like, Orphan Black ship that I got is Allison and Donnie. But they're a married couple. And, yeah, I guess it's, you know, sure, yeah, ship them. I mean, yeah, so, yeah, I guess I ship them. But, in a sense, it's like, it's not like, oh my gosh, that's my ship. They're my ship, but for that particular show, it's not saying a lot of much. Like, I don't really ship anything else. Because usually, I'm the type to, like, I could find a ship with anything, in a sense. Like, don't get me with Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Like, this is a ship for everybody on that shit, in a sense. You can't not watch that show and not find a ship. And it could be the most weirdest what the fuck ship. Somebody else is shipping that shit. You feel me? There's a lot of crack ships that can go down in a Buffy Vampire Slayer. I'm getting distracted. Yo, them abs though. I'm about to take it up a notch on a creepy level because I'm about to click the abs again. Because the Nagarita, yo. Like, I low key want to be creepy at this point and like tweet. It's like, girl, no abs. And just say that. And just. Is Nagura single? I know Norman Reedus be trying to get up in that, and I don't blame him. It seems like he's been trying to hit since like season 3. If you don't know what the fuck I'm talking about, then watch any interview with Norman Reedus and the Nagurita. I pronounced the last name. I butchered the shot of that just now. I'm blaming it on the sinuses, but this is running way long. I'm not talking about anything. Yo, them abs though. Like, I'm so stuck on it. I'm gonna sleep good tonight. Between this and what the fuck I saw, I don't know what's gonna happen. Rashawn is everything. This is probably one of the best ships I've ever shipped. And I've shipped. This is a ship that hasn't fucked me over. Like, it got sketchy a bit with the whole Jesse thing, but even then, I was like, you know, even though a lot of Rashawners was like, oh, fuck Jesse. I didn't hate Jesse. I just felt she wasn't right for Rick. And it's not necessarily because I was Rashawner. But. Jesse was just, she, not a capable being. She wasn't exactly a great mother, when you think about it. When you really think about it, it's like, Jesus Christ. And she tried, though, I give her that. She tried. She just wasn't a good fit. And she definitely wasn't certain that Rick needed. in his life. Like, motherfucker, you don't need that in your life at all. Flip it out. Pete. I'm not even drunk. I just want to put that out there. I think it's because it's so late. It's almost 6 o'clock in the morning. Right now. My sinuses are acting up. I might need to take some more medicine or something. Oh, I like my tea. I'm so tired. I don't sleep much. That's another reason why I can't get these jumps out on a decent time, because my sleep is fucked up. What was I talking about? The Mavs, though. That's the only thing my mind keep going back to. Oh, shit. Rick almost died. Did I talk about that? Michonne almost died. Maybe that's what the fuck I'm supposed to be talking about this whole time. This whole fucking after shit. Instead of fucking Michonne's abs. Maybe that's... I don't know. I haven't watched, I know Yvette was on, Talking Dead. That's another reason why I knew it was gonna be... another reason I knew it was gonna be a Michonne episode. Because, I was like, they got Yvette on this shit. When it was like, Yvette's gonna be on Talking Dead next week. Like, Michonne. I guess I gotta talk about that. I want to focus on her abs, but my girl was... Think about her. And I feel exactly where she's coming from. It's kind of like... Because she does not want to go through that trauma again. That trauma. And she went through that trauma more fucked up than Rick. Like, Rick just lost his... He had to kill his best friend. That's trauma in itself. And he lost his wife, who he wasn't exactly on the best terms with. But he did gain a baby, and he still has a son. Now, Michonne, you know. Sorry, I got chills. I lost the drink. Anyways, I can't fucking breathe right now. I'm so sorry. Michonne, we saw what Michonne was like. Even when she was with Andrea, she was very closed off, very shut down. And it was the result of her losing not only her man, what's that dude? Her significant other, such as Rick. She lost her significant other, but she lost her son. And that's how she slipped into the fucking darkness, or the trauma. You know, she was clearly like someone who suffered from PTSD. it fucked her up. And like Rick, who was able to, in a sense, come back. He had so many people to lean on. Michonne didn't have that, you know. Not until she met Andrea, and even then, she was very closed off with Andrea, which is part of, in my opinion, the rift between the two characters. Part of the big rift between Andrea and Michonne, because Michonne was so closed off to Andrea, and Andrea was like, yo, like, you're supposed to be riding out, it was good. I should make a video of why I actually don't mind a lot of the characters most of the fandom hate, but because I don't think I've had a character on this show. There's been a character on the show that I actually hated. Oh wait, Daryl. What? I did that in the Rant and Rave joke. I hate him now, but I hate it. It's mostly his existence. But. This video is going way too fucking long. And, I think I'm going to put this in a separate video. I have to. There's no way I can put this in the same shit as the actual reaction. Oh, yeah. Anyways. But, yeah. Michonne, she, she wasn't. So it was almost like she was like reliving. It's very fucked up because Michelle, in a sense, has closed a part of herself off, in a sense. Like I said, like I've been saying for a while, like she still hasn't even told Rick about her son. You know? And all Rick knows is she got a dead boyfriend. You feel me? Yeah, she put that out there in season 3. It was like, you know, I got a new boyfriend I talk to sometimes. Shit happens. I can't fucking breathe. But he doesn't know anything about her son, which is a big difference. Like, I think it's she that's one of the big Michonne moments I need. Carl knows. He's known since season 4 about Michonne's dead son. Her son Andre. Rick has no fucking idea. Cause see, Carl's, cause Michonne's like, cause Carl was, when she told him, and you know, he said, he was like, I promise, you know, like, I won't, and he's like, he said, I won't tell anybody. It's just like, you know, it's okay if you do. He's like, yeah, but, you know, I'm not. You know, he was understanding, it's just like, that's something very personal to her. Like, motherfucker, if you want to know, then you tell him, you know? She'll tell you, you feel me? I just realized, Rick, when Michonne was like, if you keep watching, he was like, you know, I like it. And he later says, you know, he doesn't sleep. That's why so I guess that's why he doesn't really have a problem keeping watch, because he motherfucking don't sleep anyways, so it's like, you feel me? I feel you. Well, I don't sleep much because I got ADHD, but that's a whole different topic. Is Sanagura single? Like I asked this already. I've been wanting to know for a minute though, for like a few years now. It's like, y'all, what it do? I just saw some pictures of her. She was at Lupita's birthday party for Coming to America. It was a Coming to America theme, and she was there in Danai Gurira. Was dressed as the queen, or well, was supposed to, Eddie Murphy's character, I can't think of his name right now, was supposed to marry. Walk like a dog. She's your queen to be. How fucking fitting. I always forgot the first one to talk about, but I was talking about Michonne and her feelings. Oh shit, I think it's sunrise. I can see it through the fucking, oh shit. Yeah, the sun's coming up. I can see it. I can see the light. Does this count as day drinking? I never slept though, so it's not like I woke up and drank. And it's not like I'm drunk. I think it's because I'm sick and my brain is like, all I'm thinking about is abs. And I'm looking over here, the sun is really rising. It's like, wow, it's 6:08 right now. I just need Rick and Michonne together. I just need, like, something about that pairing. Like, it just feels like, it feels good. Yeah. It feels good. something about it, you know, you feel me? It's just so good. It's just, it's one, it's so, it feels real, you know? Like, I don't know, it's like a fantasy inside realness, and it's just like merged together. It's just like, this is what you get, you feel me? Like, this is some good shit. Like, the way they just interact, when they look at each other. And a lot of it is just, and I love that it's, the way it's played out, it's like, before they went canon, it was Rick and Michelle being, you know, it was a lot of intensity. But like, very much a serene feeling at the same time. And it's like that now, but in a different sense. And before, it was like intensity, like such as like, it was just like, it felt like sexual tension. But like, it was never like, they were butt heads. Last time, the motherfuckers like legit butt fuck heads. But fuck it. Was when they met. Well, when it was season 3, you know? They never had beef, you know? I mean, sure, Michelle punched him in the back of his head, but even Rick woke up and was like, you know what? I deserve that. That's how you knew Rick was completely wet. It's like, motherfucker just like straight up punched you in the back. But I always loved that part. I think I mentioned something. Actually, no. Yeah, I should have made a reference to it, but that not last episode, which was 11, when they met 10, when they met Judas. I'm calling that bitch Judas, the bitch with the fucking sci-fi bomb haircut, Judas. I was just listening to the Judas song by Lady Gaga earlier. That's my shit, but Judas. She was I think I mentioned something about Tara. It was something about Tara Rosita. Oh, yeah. I forgot already. Shit. I think it was something like, I remember. See, I was going to take it somewhere else. I was going to take it somewhere else. I remember that, but I was going to take it to a different place. I was going to be like, oh yeah, you know, you should be a friend and like, fuck your friend when they got you. No. That's not where I was going. I was saying, that Rosita. I was saying that Tara should punch Rosita in the face, because sometimes as a friend you should do that. And I actually do ship Tara Rosita, but Rosita's getting on my nerves lately. But so has Rick multiple times. Rick has got I used to steal the shit out of Rick many times. Just so my fucking kid. What the fuck is that? Hey, bitch. What the fuck is that, man? I don't know. No, I think it was like an ant or something. How random. But anyways. But, oh no, the comparison was like when Michelle punched Rick in the back of the fucking head. And I was just, sorry, it was just me thinking about that, and right now, thinking about that throwback moment, and it's like me kind of mentioning that that's what a real friend should fucking do. I was having a full fucking boring discussion before, I can't remember what the fuck it was about. Pretty much, if your friend's wild the fuck out, sometimes you gotta punch him in the fucking face. Do it. I don't think I've ever actually had to do it. I've cussed them out. I may have slapped somebody before. But we're in the zombie apocalypse. Strange circumstances come into play. Sometimes you get a throat punch, motherfucker. Hey, motherfucker, chill the fuck out. Because that's what friends are for. Friends are there to tell you to sit your bitch ass fucking down. Because you wild the fuck out. If your friend can't do that, who the fuck else is gonna do it? Well, your enemy might. But, are you really gonna listen to that? The enemy? Really? I can't freaking breathe, and the sun is really up. Like, it feels like so. Like, I can hear the fucking birds. Those birds that make those noise when the sun comes up. It's always the same shit every time. Oh shit, it's empty. Oh. Don't judge me. Please don't judge me. And I won't judge you. I would say like, comment, subscribe, share. But I might take that share the fuck off, because maybe I don't want nobody to see this fucking video. I'm still gonna post it, obviously, because you couldn't just watch it. But, yeah. If you have some thoughts about the episode, that clearly I've obviously missed. Oh, wait a fucking minute. Was he trying to get my girl Sasha killed? Maybe did I talk about this in the beginning of the video? I might have. I'm not the beginning of the video. Well, I'm splitting this up. I'm putting my thoughts in a different video. I don't know what the fuck is going on anymore. I'm dying. Like, this has been bad. I got medicine I'm supposed to be taking. But, Rosita better not get Sasha killed. If Sasha, like, I think I could accept Sasha dying. It would suck and it would piss me the fuck off. Like, Sasha's one of my favorite fucking characters. You already took my Glenn. You already took my A, motherfuckers. You take Sasha from me, I'm be in my fucking. Oh no! Oh, pour this medicine real quick. Okay. Oh no. So, if you haven't read the comics, stop the fuck here. Just know that like, comment, subscribe, share. You know how the fuck it goes, motherfucker. Come back, because that's who it is, that's you can. Alright, stop here. And I may just be delirious at the moment. Maybe. It wasn't the champagne, believe me. It really wasn't. No, I'm not drunk at all. This isn't drunkenness at all, now that I'm thinking about it. I'm just really tired from lack of sleep for the past few days. And possibly the medicine that... No, I don't even think it's that. Because now I'm thinking about this. I've been taking daytime medicine this whole time. Bada bing, bada fucking boom. What was I talking about? Comics. Sasha. And for a while now, I've been thinking about comic wise Michonne in a sense, you know, Andrea. Oh fuck, especially since now Michonne can actually shoot shit with a fucking sniper rifle. Because remember, you know, Andrea is the best shot in the comics. We know this. Sasha is the best shot in the fucking show. We know this. But in the storyline, it says, you know, they have to change shit up because Andrea's fucking dead. So they gotta split shit up, swap, dip it, flip it, what the fuck ever. Hell, Carol, if they was going based on the comics, Carol should have been dead like a long fucking time ago. In the most fucked up way. That's like one of the most fucked up deaths in the fucking comics. no one's actually had that fucking depth yet, and I've been waiting. Oh man. Anyways, I'm getting distracted again. You feel me? What the fuck I was talking about? Okay, now I remember. So, what the fuck I was supposed to talk about? Michelle knows how to shoot a rifle. There's a specific scene after the initial attack against the Saviors. They obviously killed Negan. They killed everybody, but they did do a beast-ass attack, a good attack. Now Holly, Sasha is taking the role of Holly, the chick that was an assist, and Rosita as well. Rosita, I don't think she really, I can't remember. See, that's how you know it's significant Rosita was for the fucking comics, because, which is really fucked up when you think about it. Was this in a sense that I do like they put Rosita more into the sunrise, like the sun is up. The sun is pretty much up. Rosita, I do enjoy that Rosita is in the show more than intertwined. I do enjoy that Rosita is more intertwined with the show than she was in the comics. Just, you know, reading the comics. I mean, I knew beforehand, but actually reading the comics, like, damn, dude. Okay. It's another character like that that gets killed off. I still love in the show that it is gonna that they get cut off with it. He gets cut off with the show. Now I was like, what? Maybe because I, you know, I was watching the show beforehand that when it happened, it's like, I'm reading the comics when that character's death was just like, what the fuck? But Michelle, no, Sasha, that's what I was talking about. No, it's just why with the Michelle job. So anyways, Michelle, Sasha's the resident sniper of the series. That's why I always, like, you can't kill Sasha. She's the best shot in the fucking show. Like, she's shooting wise, she's Andrea. In the shooting sense, she's Andrea. You can't fucking kill her. But now that they just showed, and there's a specific scene in the comments. Like, oh shit, I explained this already. Okay, now I remember what the fuck it was. Where, when after the what you call this attack, Andrea, Alexandria and everybody, when I attacked the Saviors, Holly, who in a sense is Sasha's character, attacked the Saviors to give revenge on Abraham. She gets killed. And it says, I'll explain how. Holly crashes in the Saviors compound after the attack. She gets captured though. And she gets captured, and Negan thought she was Andrea, because he knows Andrea is Rick's, Andrea is Rick's, girl, so he thinks, so show-wise, if, you know, Abraham's girl, aka Sasha, does a fucked up attack, and gets captured, and Negan initially thinks that's Michonne, even though they look nothing alike. Every one of those, oh, all black people look alike type of situations. Which is a thing, believe me. So, Negan be one of those, like, oh, I thought Sasha was, or maybe one of the other Saviors think that, oh, that's Rick's chick. Even though it's never been successfully stated. Like, I said this a few years ago. Negan knows Rick gave that shit away. He knows, like, well, at least knows that Michonne is very important to that motherfucker. And not to mention, Michonne peeped up when Carl was about to get his shit chopped. But anyways, it's a different story. It's two different things that makes me upset with the fact that Sasha may die. I'm sorry, I'm extending this shit way longer than it should be. Michonne, like I said, she's getting, I guess, handy with the fucking sniper. That's the shit that worries me. Because it's a specific scene with Andrea, and Sasha's been sniper Andrea, the sniper Andrea version. Taking the role as the sniper from Andrea. And it's, but Andrea is Rick's girl, not Michonne in the comics, so it gets confusing. So in the tower, when Negan's retaliating, Sasha's in the tower, but she gets attacked by the Saviors in the tower while Negan and Rick's having an exchange. And it's a big fucking reveal, like, Andrea. It looks like Andrea gets thrown out the fucking tower. There's a body. Andrea's hanging out of the tower, and then a body gets thrown out, and it looks like it's Andrea. And Ray's like, oh shit. You know, that's this fucking girl. So it's like, oh shit, like, you got me fucked up, motherfucker. Like, are you dead ass? So that, but it says, I guess that, but it affects. Well, the reason why that scene was so effective because Andrew was Rick's girl. So you got Sasha, who takes the role as the sniper. It's not gonna have the same effect as it does in the comics. It's gonna have some effect because Sasha's been in the show since season 3. But that's not his girl. Rick is Rick. That dread feeling is like, oh shit, I probably get this. I finally found, like, actual true love again, and then I just watch her plummet to her fucking death. And I was not gonna, so that's why they set up Michonne to be the sniper for that specific scene. That's what I'm saying. But I'm worried about Sasha. Sasha's the resident. But anyways, yeah, like I was saying before, that's why. Cause Holly. Holly in the comics is the chick that Abraham leaves Rosita for. Actually, he was cheating on Rosita with Holly. In the show, he leaves Rosita, and then a couple episodes later, he finally takes that plunge to get with. Yeah, take that space from Sunny Fight. Sorry, takes that plunge to get with. What is that girl's name? Sasha. Sorry. Base. Anyways, which so when Holly crashes into the place, I should say this a long time ago. This might be completely fucked up in editing, but whatever. I don't know. It's probably gonna edit it, so you can laugh at me about my whatever. Holly, like I said, gets captured. They thought she was Andrew. This is white girl with like short, with some broad red hair. I don't know. I don't remember what the fuck Holly looks like. She gets captured. They thought she was Andrea. Like, nope, motherfucker. Wrong, motherfucker. Holly was her revenge, but she doesn't get killed. What am I talking about? Anyways, when the confrontation goes down, like I said, Michonne gets thrown out the fucking. I guess TV-wise, I'm talking TV-wise. Michonne would be the one to get thrown out the fucking world, or what you call it. You know, not really, but that's how it's gonna fucking appear. And then, they're supposed to do an exchange. This was a drop off Holly. But Holly has a bad girl with me. And that. She's a fucking walker. It was a setup. That's how Denise was supposed to fucking die. In a sense. Because Denise dies. That's why I was so pissed about. I hope Tara doesn't die that way. honestly don't know how this shit's gonna go. Tara, there's no fucking Denise on the show anymore. Closest shit we had was, what the fuck is that dude's name? Eugene, but he's rolling with Negan now. It's so fucking fucked up and confusing. It's like, what the fuck is going on, say? But anyways, Holly, which would be Sasha in a sense, turn up. I don't know who the fuck beat Denise, but it turns out bitch is fucking dead. That's the fucking point. I don't want Sasha to fucking die. And she dies because of Rosita. I'm gonna be very pissed because she's already got people. What the fuck, man? She already got Eugene snatched. And then wants to blame Father Gabriel. I get it. Like I said, I get it. Like, you just want to blame someone else. I don't condone it. It's not okay. That's the way I don't get it. That's why she'd be in the Ranting Baby video with Lord Costello. Like, bitch, I get it. That's the way I agree with it. And you do shit. Calm the fuck down. Anyways, I'm stopping here. I'm so fucking tired. Like, comment. Oh, shit. Like, comment, subscribe, share. It is 6:33 a.m. Shit. Sun's out. I need to go to sleep. I really do. Like, it's to the point I don't even need this fucking lamp here. Why is this lamp here? Fucking put that there. Like, comment, subscribe, share. What the fuck you thought of this episode, man? I mean, you probably put it on the watch episode, the video that I watched the actual episode on. But, I'm so tired. I just hope things just work out. So like, comment, subscribe, share. Come back. Because Ashley will. Because Ashley can.